tonight's guest was part of one of the UK's biggest girl groups, the Nolans. Anne Nolan joins me, and in a moment, I'm going to be talking to her about her latest venture. But first, should we take a trip down memory lane?
The Nolans were one of Britain's best-known singing groups and reached the peak of their success in the 70s. Made up of five sisters, the group worked alongside some of the biggest names in show business and were handpicked to tour with Frank Sinatra in 1975. But it was this hit which became their anthem and the biggest-selling single of their career. After worldwide record sales of 25 million, the group split in the 90s, but in 2010, the Nolans reunited for a comeback tour. You had the wrong story. Now Anne is releasing her first single in 4 years, You've Heard the Wrong Story. But if you hear
the right story... And Anne's with me now. This is exciting, isn't it?
Yeah, it's really good fun, actually, you know, at my age, to be asked to go and record a single.
Yeah.
It's good,
and
yeah.
Can I ask what your age is?
Yes, I'm 63. I'll be 64 in November.
No, it's not. I mean, it's just great fun to be doing this.
It is. It's amazing, to be asked to do it. And it's just, you know, I'm not trying to make a new career or anything. It's just good fun to go into the studio and record and have, you know, a lot of fun. And then if something happens with it, well, that'll be even more amazing, you know?
And why not? And what's the song about?
It's about somebody, people talking about somebody behind their back and telling to their partner and telling them things that went on that are not true. So, it's, you know, the title speaks for itself, really. You've heard the wrong story.
Okay. And is it still as much fun, music, now? Do you still like it as much?
I've always loved music since I started singing when I was 12. So that's a long time. So I like all kinds of music. My favourite kind of music is like Sinatra. That kind of stuff, but I do listen to all kinds of music. I love it, yeah. And today's still great music as well. Yeah.
Didn't you perform with Sinatra at one point?
We did. We did a European tour with him in, 1975. And it was absolutely amazing. We did all massive big arenas with him. Yeah. And he was just fantastic. You know, we'd heard a lot, you know, if people do hear a lot of bad stories about him.
You told the wrong story, in fact.
Oh, very good, yeah. Yeah, but he was lovely. He was great. Yeah, great fun.
So, I mean, that must have been a sort of a slice of kind of what your life was then. I mean, when you look at that, 25 million records sold, extraordinary success at such a young age as well. Can you look back and sort of relish the memories, or were they, is it dizzy-making in a way?
I look back. At the time when you're in that kind of thing, you don't realise how amazing it is. Even the bad times, when you look back, you think, well, it wasn't... Because we toured Russia as well, and, I mean, we know there was no food. It was a really hard tour. Mm. But looking back, it was the most amazing experience. Everything I look back on, I think of, even the bad bits, were a fantastic experience.
Do you miss it and miss performing with your sisters?
I did. I kind of don't anymore because I've got lots of other things now. I've got, like, I'm doing stuff on my own, and I've got two grandsons, which occupy my time a lot as well, so that's
nice. Always good fun.
Yeah.
And you have had time when you've been estranged from your sisters, haven't you?
I have, yes. That was about, about 4 or 5 years ago now. Yeah, we fell out. And I'm happy to say that we're now back together again, and we speak to each other all the time. Yeah. I wrote them a letter saying, look, let's just agree to disagree. And two of my sisters, myself and Denise, wrote the letter, and Maureen and Bernie said, yes, we'd love to do that. And then when Bernie got really sick afterwards, Colleen and Linda got back with us as well. So,
it's a lot you've been through as a family, isn't it?
Yeah,
we have had a lot of bad health, and obviously poor Bernie. It seems a lot to be crammed into one family, but I guess all families
We're a big
have.
Family, yeah, I know. I think it's because we're in the limelight as well, people think. But when you think about it, like you say, there are families who have terrible times as well, you know, you just don't hear about them. But because we're celebrities, I suppose, you know, it looks like we've had it. I mean, we have had a hard time. Three of us have had breast cancer. And we've had, you know, ups and downs throughout our career and stuff like that. But we've had an amazing life as well. It's been fabulous.
I mean, we all enjoy, talking of celebrity, we all enjoyed watching Linda in Celebrity Big Brother. Were you watching as well?
Yes, but I don't think I enjoyed it very much, I'm afraid.
Oh, why?
Well, because, you know, the programme is edited and it depends on who's editing it, whether they're going to make a person look good or bad. I mean, I've spoken to Linda since she came out and she hasn't actually watched the programme because of all the bad publicity that she got from it. But she said it wasn't like that at all. She said, I had an amazing time. I go back in heartbeat. She said it was fabulous, but lots of laughs, lots of fun, with Jim as well. Yeah. And they just show the bits where, you know, the controversial bits, I suppose, because that's what the programme's all about, you know.
Yeah.
So it was very difficult for me to watch it, really.
So you don't fancy anything like that yourself?
I don't know. If they paid me that much money, I would.
See how the single sells, maybe, in the meantime.
They might be begging me to go in. You never know.
Well, it's lovely to chat to you.
Thank you.
Good luck with the single and being a granny. My goodness, I bet that's a fun one.
It's amazing.
Lovely to chat to you.
Thank you.
Thanks very much indeed.